means you guys.
So, over the last few videos,
thing that we've all been chasing.
For look, we were looking at Kalala, we looked.
Like, what we're trying to do is
have with us something.
And the fact that.
Welcome back to the podcast, Chaitanya. It's good to have you finally. Long time coming.
Long conversation, bro.
Chaitanya's been, I mean, we've known you since like inception, dude. Since before there was a store.
Before that was the sneaker scene.
Before there was a sneaker scene. And there's still no real
before that was
scene.
Che.
Before that was Che.
Yeah, that
Che,
was, I think that
brand.
Was the first drop that we ever went to, right? It was the first easy drop.
First time I met him was before that.
Blutin
launch. And before that, I had come for the previous Zebra restock.
Yeah, I wasn't there.
You weren't there, okay.
No.
So our first interaction, I remember, we were just setting up the store at a very, very nascent stages and we were picking up stock. Long time, dude.
Yeah,
we've come a long way.
Long time. Super long time.
Interesting
back.
To see how far.
Now the time we can give that Bape thing.
Yeah.
The Bape Mickey Mouse.
Chaitanya painted us like this super cute round canvas with
picture
like
will be over here.
Mickey Mouse wearing a pair of Bape shorts. It's in my room hungry.
Yeah.
I have it.
Like Bape shorts and Bape NMDs.
Yeah, that was dope as well.
Yeah, that was sick.
That was sick stuff.
Long journey, dude. I want to know journey. More about. Has art always been the direction you've been at?
I've been an artist for the long, like, I can't call myself an artist, but like, I've been doing art for the longest
everybody's
time.
Everybody's an artist.
Yeah, everybody's an artist. I've been doing art for the longest time, like, been painting, making murals, making artworks on canvas.
So it's usually been paint and color.
Yeah,
visual art
that,
is what you've been into, physical visual art. And when did it translate to, what's the first custom you remember doing? Why did you do it? How did it happen?
So like first custom shoe I made for someone was for Hriday Purohit.
Okay.
Made the,
Aman.
Yeah. We made the Bape Vans for him. Like a black
That was
and
the
white.
First custom?
Yeah.
Because like, he saw you painting other stuff.
And the first
like,
custom I made for myself was a pair of Adidas Superstars. I cut the whole thing apart, made it again with denim.
Is that your first, is that the only custom you ever worn of yourself?
I've never worn them.
Oh, you never worn those either?
But they're just
on my
for
size.
So you just did that for yourself, like a passion project kind of thing.
So like, this was during my board exams.
Of 10th grade?
Of 12th.
Okay.
Of 12th, yeah.
The elusive 12th
grade. Yeah, and I wasn't the guy who always like studied 12 hours a day, did that.
Yeah.
So because I had free time during that time, so this was my cousin's pair that he gave me. And I just sat at home that day, 6 hours I took, cut the poor pair apart, put it back again with denim. It was my first custom. But that was something different because I was just getting bored and I did that. It came out pretty beautiful, very nice, very clean costume. With all like ripped denim kind of a vibe going around it. But after that, next day, like after I came back for my exam, I did one more costume. Which was the Joshua Weeds inspired superstar.
Yeah.
That went very nice. And after that, people were like, oh wow, she's making costumes. She's making costumes now, it's nice.
Yeah, dude, you're the favorite son of the sneaker industry.
Yeah.
Everybody loves you. Everybody, it's beautiful. Yeah. It's so cool to see. Dude. You've been because A, there's no conflict of interest. B, for some reason, I see almost no one else trying to do this.
That's true.
No one has tried to compete. I haven't seen anybody try to compete.
I mean, I think of late we have a few things. There's one in Bangalore, if I'm not wrong.
But so Vaishak.
Yeah, Vaishak.
These guys, they do custom, but no one is so deep in just sneaker customizing. You know, Chaitanya has been at it as just, this is what I do, this is my thing. Everybody's like, this is the best in this game. No one's trying to mess with it.
But I never call myself the best sneaker customizer. But like,
you shouldn't.
I shouldn't.
Be humble.
Yeah. Like, but half the time, all the people are like, when I put up a custom post.
That's what I'm saying. So much love. It's beautiful.
Best customizer in the game, this in the game. I'm like, bro, have you seen outside? Like, there's so many people doing the same shit I'm doing.
I mean, but honestly,
it's
is there
something new for the market,
it's
right?
More of, I mean, you're writing your own story, dude.
Yeah.
And is that, I mean, the when you say there's people doing more. That's really not your fault, right? I mean, since the superstar which you said, you ripped it out and ran a denim thing. Since then, how many people even have the guts to tell you, cut apart my shoe and do what you want?
Yeah, that's the problem. Not the problem, that's like a thing in India
barrier?
Where people get kind of scared to experiment. But like, it's not my pair, it wasn't my pair. That's why I was like, fuck it, let me just do it. Even if it's ruined, song. What do I do about it?
And now Chaitanya has become Che, and Che has become Che Labs, the brand. Yeah. And
Che Labs is like a small baby project of mine. It's just all behind the scenes, what's happening.
Che Labs should be like the...
Yeah, it's gonna be the brand name.
The
like
store.
If I get my own studio, it's gonna be called Che Lab.
Yeah. But is that coming soon? Is that a plan for soon?
Hopefully, yeah.
That's sick.
In the works.
So, I mean, like I said, you have really been able to do a lot with customs. Do you feel that holds you back a little bit? You know, if someone, let's suppose, gave you a pair and said, do what you want with it, do you think there's a lot more you could do than you are doing right now?
Yeah.
Yeah? Like, what kind of stuff do you want to do? Tell me, like, what do you want to expand into? The customization.
So, and let's have people hit you up, man. Yeah. If you like one of these ideas, hit the comments, DM him, DM us, we'll get it get it done.
100%.
Yeah. Let's go next. So hit us with 5 ideas that you haven't been able to do today that you really want to.
Yeah.
So like, there's this one idea that I had of taking a pair of grey joggers, Nike joggers, cutting them apart and making it into a shoe.
What kind of shoe?
Like an Air Force One. Just making it into a shoe, like adding the elements, the zippers, the elastic thing. Like, I want the myriad vibe to be there.
So you want to do a hybrid, if I'm not wrong.
So you make a sock shoe.
Kind of a sock shoe, but like,
with the elastic.
It has the exact nada of the jogger, like that.
That's a sick idea, dude. Let's do this.
It'll be a sick idea.
I'll take that.
Let's do that.
We'll drop it on the... We can take an Air Force One, we'll take a pair of joggers, we'll make it a sock shoe. I love sock shoes.
Yeah.
And so like, we can flip the sock end of things and have it go down onto the Air Force.
Yeah.
And then add the elements to the zippers and the laces on top, and that'd be dope.
We can add some ambush kind of vibe with the zipper.
We'll auction them off.
Sick. Yeah, we can do that.
We'll auction them off. But anyway, we're planning to do 5 pairs of shoes. We're gonna pick a design. We're gonna do 5 pairs in a full size run.
Ooh.
Full size run, shout out. And we'll drop them on the Mainstreet marketplace, and let's see what kind. So let's have people comment below what kind of silhouettes they're looking for, what kind of colors they're looking for. We'll pick a design. We'll put it up on our gram, and we'll get 5 done.
Right.
Go on anyway. So you wanna do a jogger? What's next? You already have a buyer there.
Oh yeah, this is a Sakai classic Reeboks, inspired by the Sakais.
You know, Sakai Reebok classic?
Yeah. So like, I put double laces, double tongues, the middle section of the shoe, like with the Vector logo. Everything's double on the shoe. So I don't know, like...
I mean, I wouldn't want to discourage you, but like, the Sakai is a pair, I don't know if you've seen the video, but it's one I genuinely don't like.
I don't love it, bro. Please, go for it.
I like it, but...
We sold a few pairs at the store, everybody loves it.
I mean, this is something I couldn't really see on camera, but you know how you have those... Look at the midsole now. It's like one of those,
this thing on the back.
It's like a
bumper. Like a paperweight.
Not even
on the
a
back.
Bumper, I have to feel it's like, you know those beds? Yeah. The mattress ends here, but the bed extends.
Goes
it irritates me to watch this.
Exactly, looks like
I
that.
I hate this shoe. I don't know.
I like
the
shoe.
It's
beautiful. It's nice, but.
So, hybrid?
A Reebok would look nice because it's like classic Reebok.
But would you.
I love the.
So is there a, is something you want to do?
Shout out.
Is there something you want to do the hybrid between two shoes? Would you like to like construct two shoes into one, like an MX97x1, like an LD waffle.
Like a midsole rechange or something.
Yeah,
like
so what are two shoes you'd want to merge then? Just think of it.
Probably an Air Force One and an MX1.
MX1?
Yeah.
Okay, so anyway, we've been through Nike Jogger X, Nike Air Force One, Sakai Waffle
Reebok.
X, Reebok Classic. Third. Let's give us a third studio that you want to do.
This is the Nike Air Force One inspired by the Travis 6.
Oh wow. Ooh. That's actually pretty sick, bro.
Oh wow.
I think I would get
you
that
draw that
on? Sure.
Yeah.
Damn.
With the pouch, you're gonna add the pouch?
Yeah.
This one I would buy for sure.
Okay, this is cool. What's the fourth?
It's this one.
So what is this?
This is like an Air Force One. Like it has
Sky
an ocean
blue?
On it. Like
okay, ocean blue.
Complete ocean on it.
Right.
This is inspired by the Stranger Things collab.
Nice.
Okay. Kind of.
So it's gonna have these plastic overlays all over the stitching.
Hmm.
And when you remove the plastic, you can see the ocean. Like going behind the idea. Remove the plastic and see the fucking ocean.
Nice.
Even this one. It's very simple,
but
instead of drawing the shit down,
I want to cut
the swoosh out in such a way
that just says swoosh.
That's a great idea.
Like,
take
that
my
so
knife
dope.
And like, cut
you want to cut out the swoosh into just
into
the words.
Just the swoosh thing, yeah. That's
that
a great idea.
Dope.
Like it's,
I like,
that. Without removing the swoosh.
That is super dope, dude.
That's a great idea.
So we got these 5 shoes up for auction.
Yeah.
Let's have bids in the comments below and we'll get them done in the next 3 weeks. 3 weeks?
Yeah.
3 weeks is cool. 3 weeks. Let's have bids in the comments, DM us on Instagram, we'll get this one.
100%.
With your sizes and your demands. I think I kind of sort of remember my question. I was going to talk about how you work with all the big brands. You've been through Puma, Reebok, Adidas,
Puma, actually, we should mention you did Puma Masaba, right? You were working with them on the project.
Yeah.
You were working with them on the project, right?
Yeah.
You helped them do the customizations of
this. Yeah, so they gave me the design. Right. And they gave me 25 pairs of shoes and they told me just put the design down on the shoes.
That's brilliant.
Pretty easy, but like it was a good custom.
What's your experience been like working with some of these bigger brands?
So I've worked
with Puma. Did you expect to do it so soon?
No, man. It's a dream. It was nice. Yeah. Like, it's too fast. Like, it happened and I was like,
everything's now? Like, it's in a boom.
It's like
already?
6 months and you've done it already. Cool. Yeah, because when I started customizing in April last year, and then almost in December, I got my contract with Reebok.
Okay. Like,
saying that you're sponsored by Reebok and do this shit. I was like, fuck, wow, that's nice.
Yeah, that is very nice.
Got power going on over here. And then I worked with Adidas on the Oslico campaign.
Yeah, that was sick.
Yeah. I mean, that was like, because Adidas is one brand that got me into the sneaker thing. Like, wearing superstars.
Likewise, I think.
Just buying my first pair of NMDs and being like, oh fuck, this is hype.
That's common to the whole table here. NMD,
yeah, like,
easy.
Nikes were like not there anywhere at that time. Like, they were there, they were Air Force One and shit. But like the Nikes that people wanted were Air Jordan 1s.
They were just not that much in India.
Yeah, the shoe that technically got me into sneaker culture was like that NMD.
Yeah, same. I got the vintage white ones. Still not. I don't wear them that much, but like that's
customizing
the
first
them. Pair of shoes.
Never.
Beautiful.
Can't touch these shoes.
They're beautiful the way they are.
Any other regrets in the in the sneaker game like you did with the NMD City Sock? You have any other regrets?
A lot of them, man.
You know, they say live life with no regrets.
Any silhouettes that go that you really wanted?
The Travis Scott AJ ones, bro. Like the CJ ones.
At what price?
Don't ask.
Oh, bad price.
So, I mean, like Vedant spoke about working with big brands. I want to talk about like, you know, working with celebrities. Like we mentioned in the last video, you've designed a pair of shoes now for Wiz Khalifa, for Ranbir Kapoor, Ranveer Singh.
Anand Ahuja.
And of course, Anand.
Harshvardhan, a lot of people, man.
That's my point. So, I mean, can you tell me what it's like working with these guys? Like, do you see an increased impact when you are customizing for the celebrities? What does it impact?
Yeah, how do your posts perform? Do you see greater traction when there's like a celebrity involved or when it's a cool shoe?
When it's a cool shoe. Right. Like, a lot of time it's happened.
Responses a lot more with that.
Depends on the design, man. A lot of people get
so following is also more about your art than it is about the celebrity clientele.
Like, but that's a lot of them again, like, keep like, hey, I'm a big fan of Harshan Kapoor. Can you please tell him to reply on my message?
Oh, wow. Oh, wow. You get that?
I get that a lot. A lot of people just randomly message me because I made a pair for Alia Bhatt too, right?
Yeah, I know that. I gave on the cover show.
So for that also a lot of people are like, oh, we are very big fan of Alia, please tell us.
We also big fans of Harshvardhan, can you please ask him to come on the podcast
for us? Oh, actually Harshvardhan is getting one shoot tonight by me.
Which one?
It's a secret.
It's a secret?
Yeah.
Oh man, it'll be out by
Oh yeah, it'll be out.
It'll be out by Saturday, so you can tell us.
It's a Yeezy 350 V2 cream. It's got this abstract art done all over it.
Artsy.
Yeah.
Send a picture of it.
So I have this thing.
Your picture.
I have a render of it.
What is your dream collaboration, dude?
Probably with Adidas. Like, I'm a Nike boy. I love Nike. But like, I want a collaboration with Adidas because I think it's...
On what pair though?
Super difficult to choose, man. Super difficult to choose.
Gotta pick one, man. Come on, let's do this. You're on the spot now.
Yeah. I'd probably fuse in an Oswego and some other silhouette. But I love the Oswego, man. A lot of people hate on it. Yeah. A lot of people hate on the Oswego, but I love the silhouette, man.
I think it's a great looking shoe.
It's a very nice shoe.
Everybody's here, a lot of our viewers, you're following, right? They're all curious about what's happening. They see you doing this, they see you doing well. And there's a lot of kids watching who also want to do the same. I'm sure they're wondering what's next.
I haven't planned anything yet. Like that's the best.
Everything's been happening.
It's just happening on its own. Yeah.
Yeah.
Like I don't plan a lot of shit. It just happens on its own.
And you're going with the flow. And
I'm just going with the flow. Yeah.
That's really cool, dude. It's very rare. I mean, to see people in. First of all, the sneaker industry in India, to see somebody make a viable income, very rare. Big ups, dude. You found your niche. You've carved your space in this. So we spoke about regrets. What is when somebody hits you up with an idea, how often do you have to say, I'm not doing that, that is too shitty?
There's one guy that has messaged me, bro. He's been messaging me for the longest fucking time. Huh. He's got these pair of Kobe's Nike Kobe's that he's got. That doesn't have a Nike swoosh on it.
Okay.
So it's fake.
It's fake. It's fake. It's fucking fake. And that guy's been telling me, can you put a Nike swoosh on this?
Oh wow, he wanted you to make his shoe look legit.
But oh, I'm like, God. Fuck no, I'm not doing it only. He's always keeping me, bro, please, I'll give you this much money, I'll give you this much money. My boy, it's not about the money, I don't want to make
the
original
shoe. Yeah, yeah,
buy the
shoe,
man. Just don't want to make a fake product into a real product. That's just shady, man.
So you get a lot of ideas, yeah?
A lot of ideas.
Okay, approximately, what would you say is your fall through rate? Right. How many people that ask you for things actually go through with it once they hear the price?
Lot of people actually, but like, it depends, bro. Like, people don't talk that much, I've realized right now. That they're not like, hey, what's up? Hey, how are you doing? What's up? That's how you start a conversation with someone, right? Half of the people just message me, how much? I'm like, what, how much? That's like walking into a tattoo parlor and you're like, how much for a tattoo? You're not explaining me what design you want, what's the size of your design. Accordingly, I can tell you something. Right. You're just walking in and you're like, oh, how much? It's not.
You reply to them?
Yeah, I don't reply to them, man.
You don't reply at all? You block anybody? You ever block anyone?
I've blocked a lot of people who like throw shit, like hate and stuff.
Huh.
But like, it's cool.
No room for haters.
No room for haters.
Are all your customers one-of-one specifically? Do you try and make them one-of-one or do you do
all
like...
All of them are one-of-one. Like so if, far. So, I made this Astro World custom for my friend Ismail. And a lot of people liked it a lot. And they all told me that we want this custom. So I did a lot. I did like 4 or 5 of them. But like, I made sure that Ismail's shoe is different from everybody else's shoe, just to get that one-of-one kind of a thing going on. If I have a pair of old schools and I make like 7 pieces of it and make like one design on them, I'll have my own freedom on making the design because it'll be my design on my shoe that I will go and that I'm gonna sell. So it's not gonna be like somebody else's shoe with somebody else's theme that given to me with my design on it.
Right.
It's gonna be my shoe, my theme, my design that people will buy if they want to or they can like not buy it.
Apple versus Windows. Exactly that.
Yeah, kind of. I don't know what I mean.
It's because Windows is an operating system. Someone picks a monitor, someone picks a CPU, someone picks all the hardware.
You want to control the end-to-end system.
I want to control everything. Yeah. Like, if this is my shoe, this is how it's going to be. Hardware, you can buy software, it, you can buy it, and you can ask me how much at that time. Not now. But ask me now.
Apple, but that's just that's like not one thing that I hate, man. How much?
Like, how much for you? and when people see it written, Rani Pink for Harshvardhan Kapoor, they're like, how much? Like, bro, it's already gone to him. What, how much?
How much? It's like,
bro, I'm telling you, if
you
I
ever wonder if
right
that's
now,
a lot of lost revenue?
It's cool, bro.
You don't care?
I don't want money from such people then. It's cool. But like, cool. We don't know how to open that. It's like common courtesy to be there.
Hello,
like,
how are
hey,
you?
Hey, how are you?
Good afternoon.
What's up? I wanted to inquire about the pricing of your custom. Talk formally, talk normally, man.
We'll make
how
a,
much?
We make a quick Insta tutorial on how to get a custom with Chaitanya Dixit.
So you go to my ID, Chaitanya Dixit, Chaitanya underscore Dixit, and you go to message me and be like, hey Chaitanya, how are you doing? Do you have food today? And
ask
I
him if he's
to
had
inquire.
Enough water, ask him if he's hydrated.
Are you hydrated?
Has he slept well previous night?
And then be like, hey, just wanted to inquire about the pricing of the customs. Please help me out. I have some designs in mind. That's cool. Just don't come to my item and how much? What is how much, bro?
I'm not saying
next
myself.
Time, if somebody's asking
hashtag
me how,
know
much,
how much, let's do
next
know how
time,
much.
Yeah, bro. If somebody's coming next time saying how much, I'm going to be like 5,000 an hour. Cool.
That's so funny, dude.
Super fucking funny.
That's
man.
So funny.
Like, how much?
So you've done
a t-shirt made it say how much.
We should do a t-shirt. How much for that? Chaitanya merch. Let's do that.
I'm coming out with clothing soon, that's
a big step. So what is your idea?
Are you trying to diversify from sneakers to clothing, other accessories, things like that?
So like, I have a lot of ideas in mind. So along with the shoes that I'll be dropping soon, there will be merch along with it that people who don't want to buy the shoes can either go for merch or
same
something.
Same design.
Like
so every line can have a super dope.
That'll
so
be like,
that's beautiful.
Like if it's a grey shoe with some details on it, it'll be
and
like
the details can be on a t-shirt, on a grey hoodie.
Like that's something that goes with the shoe.
That's cool.
Sick, dude.
Or if people who, like, even if I'm making a one-of-one custom, I'll make something similar kind of a merch with it.
For the t-shirt.
That's dope.
That'll be sick because like people who can't buy the customs can just buy the merch.
Clothing.
It'll be cool,
So we've discussed your favorite customs, the custom that you wanted but you haven't done, which we will get done.
I've
discussed the worst ideas that you've had. Bro, it's been so nice to see like this whole journey from the start.
But the best part is like every someone. Like one's a photographer, one's a chef, one's an artist, but all of them they have one thing in common, love for sneakers.
Love for sneakers. Yeah.
That's the best part.
And I think we saw at the start when we were still making videos and you know we didn't have the money to get like the fancy equipment. Like we had people like Nishant hitting us up saying, dude, I love shoes, I love what you're doing, I'm
gonna help you
shoot
out
for free.
Yeah, yeah.
It was crazy.
Nishant
Joshi is
one of the sweetest guys.
The sweetest dude, like shout out Nishant Joshi, such good photography.
Shout out Nishant Joshi, bro.
He's
like
such a good
best guy.
Yeah.
But
love that guy.
It's just beautiful to see like this whole scene
progress. Yeah, it's like beautiful. Started. And that drummers and there's so many
there's
people.
There's so many people, dude. Everybody's in
this
scene.
That's the best part.
But this has been fun, dude. Thank you so much for doing this with us.
100%, bro.
Again, this is good
see
fun.
See you soon, Chaitanya. Hopefully you can do this one again next year when you have your own.
Collab coming soon.
Messi collab coming soon. If you're not already, follow Chaitanya on Instagram at
Chaitanya_Dixit.
Dixit. Also follow his
Chaylabs
brand page.
And we just mentioned his five customs he really wants to do. We decided one that we are going to do with him. If there's one you want specifically have made or something of the sort, make
from
sure to comment.
These five options that we have out here, comment down below which ones you're looking to get.
Let's
if you
start
buy
a poll.
These, DM us, DM him. Let's see what the comments are full of.
Stay hydrated.
Yeah, and follow Mainstreet on Instagram, the Mainstreet TV, Mainstreet Marketplace. And
follow Vedu Lamba and Chris Miller too.
Yeah, just follow everybody, man. Don't follow Wags. And
that's
like,
it
comment,
from
subscribe.
Us.
We'll see you next one.
Bye.
See you guys.